Creations. If you're new to my channel and you're stopping by for the first time, thank you for stopping by. Welcome to my channel. Stick around a while by clicking that red button for more crafting on a budget, more everything on a budget videos to come. And if you click it again when the bell appears, YouTube should notify you every time I upload a new video, depending on the option that you choose in the drop-down menu of the bell. If you're interested in following me on social media, you can find those links, you guessed it, in the description box below. What have I got going on for you for today? It is the middle of April, and boy oh boy, do I have some new finds that I found at guess where? My local Dollar Tree. Boy oh boy, is Dollar Tree and Crafter Square rolling out some amazing new items that I am so excited about, and I'm excited for the future of Dollar Tree with all of the new items that Crafter Square is making for people who craft and DIY. It doesn't get any better than that. I can't wait to show you some of the new items that I found. Some are by Crafter Square and some not. Just all around really great finds, and I'm gonna tell you, I found an item that regularly costs $10.99. I'm not telling you what this item is, but yes, it costs $10.99. I bought 11 items, spending only $11 instead of $116. Wowzers, this item is amazing. This is an item that I use anyway daily, but I don't buy it too often because of its price of $10.99. I can't wait to show you that Dollar Tree is now carrying this item. You need to keep your eye open for it. So I'm gonna quit my gabbing. Let's jump into it and let me show you these great new finds that you too should keep your eye open for at your local Dollar Tree. Fingers crossed that they have it. Let's get to it. I'm gonna start today's new finds off with my absolute new favorite find. This find is probably hands down one of my most favorite finds that I've found at Dollar Tree in a while, because I love nail polish and I love a good nail polish. As most of you know, I paint my nails, I do my own nails all of the time, and buying nail polish is something that I buy a lot of. I typically stick with simple colors, but I do use the Sally Hansen gel top coat, and I use it in the gloss and in the matte. I don't buy her colors because they are $10.99 a bottle, but I will pay the $10.99 a bottle for the top coat because it really does help you to get more wear out of a less expensive polish when you put it over the top. With that being said, standing in line after I had done all my shopping at the Dollar Tree, I look over and this is what I saw. I typically buy my polish at Walgreens or Walmart, and I cannot believe the amazing buy for this. Hands down, amazing. I brought it home. All I kept thinking is, what is wrong with this polish? Is it expired? Is it not good? So I went ahead. I couldn't wait to try it on with the brown, and to my surprise, nothing was wrong with it. It was perfect, and so maybe they're just discontinuing these colors, and they had a lot of them. But I'm excited, so if you see this at the Dollar Tree, you need to pick some up, especially if you like painting your nails, because it is a $10 savings. And if those weren't enough, yeah, there was another bin that had her Extreme Wear. Her Extreme Wear nail polish, I'm not really sure what it retails for. I wanna say it's $6.99, another item that you most definitely wanna keep your eye open for. Another one of my favorite finds, oh my goodness, would you look at these? These are like for creamers, something you would store creamer in, and I absolutely loved them. They don't get any more farmhouse than that. I found these two in the white, and I found the pink here, and local and fresh. I thought that these would be so cute to gift flowers in on Mother's Day. These probably have been hauled by somebody, but this is the first time I have seen these at my Dollar Tree, these domes. It is a plastic dome. How fun are these? These are amazing. There is a lot that can be done with these. Boy, oh boy, do I have some inspiration for a couple of DIYs using these. I'm gonna say that this is another fantastic find in addition to Dollar Tree. I found this in the tool section, not the craft section. This is a window film. It's a frosted window film, and so it's something that you can very easily apply to your windows for privacy. So something like this would be perfect for those garage doors that actually have the windows on the top, if you wanted to frost them out so you had more privacy and people couldn't see into your garage. I did that at Ray's house when he moved in, because he had the 12 windows that went across and he didn't like it. So we used it, a frosted film, and it worked perfect. So I picked up a couple of these, not to use on the house, but I'm probably gonna incorporate these into a DIY because I am loving the detail on the etching on the frosted film there. Okay, seriously, how stinking cute are these? I feel like I hit the jackpot. I did hit the jackpot. Would you look at these mini clipboards? And it looks like the shipwreck. Shipwreck? Shipwreck? It's shipwreck. I did this the last time. How cute is that? And on the back, it also has a stand, so it doesn't have to be hung up. And it's got the little clip here to hang it. I found it in the white and the brown. How fun are these? These are frames that fit a 4x6 picture in them, and I am loving the shape of the house on them. How fun and different is that? So you gotta keep your eye open for these in the frame section of your Dollar Tree. I thought that this was super cute. It's in the shape of an ironing board. Laundry, wash, dry, fold. How cute is that? And it's got the clothesline pins on it. I was excited to find a couple more of these. I got some of these sent to me in my subscriber mail. I think I got 4 or 5 of them. And I had a DIY in store for you using these, but I needed 7 of them. And so I was glad to find 2 more. And I also saw that Dollar Tree finally got these back in. I had DIY'd these and did a quick bleak to chic using these in one of my Dollar Tree hauls. I just love them because on the back you can take it out. This lettering and wording comes up super easily, and these are perfect for DIYs. And so I don't have a DIY in mind for them just yet, but I wanted them to have in my stash because you never know. And I like to go looking in my stash when I'm feeling drained of inspiration. Found a couple new styles in these 12x12 self-adhesive wall tiles. If you're into that river rock look, how cool is that? I picked up one of these. And I am loving this kind of gray and white tiled look. This is a new one as well. Picked up several of these. Here is another exciting new addition to Dollar Tree by Crafter Square. This is a glass etching cream. Really? You buy this at Joann's, Michael's, Hobby Lobby, you're gonna spend anywhere from $6 to $10 on a bottle of it. And so the fact that Crafter Square has really thought of everything and they've come out with a glass etching cream, oh my word, so stinking excited. I'm so excited. I can't wait to try this out. We're gonna try it out now. Let's see how this works. So to try out this glass etching cream, I decided to pick up one of these glass square trivets from the Dollar Tree. On the back side of the trivet, it's got the smooth glass, but on the top side, it's kind of got that bumpy texture to it. So on the back side, I'm just gonna go ahead and tape down a stencil that was in my stash face down. So it looks backwards here, but we want it to, because when we flip over the trivet, it's gonna look right. So we're mirror imaging it, in essence. And so once I've got it good and taped down, the directions say to give the cream a good shake. I also stirred it with my sponge dabber. At first glance, it looks pretty good. I'm like, okay, this is nice and creamy. This is what we're going for. But as I started to dab it onto the stencil, I started noticing that the consistency of the cream wasn't consistent. It wasn't blended well. This is gonna sound horrible, but the cream looked curdled inside the container. I wasn't being heavy-handed with the etching cream, and from my experience, using a sponge dabber is the better way to go versus a brush or even a stencil brush. I like working with sponge dabbers when I'm working with stencils, and so the consistency that we're looking for when it comes to this glass etching cream is a thicker, creamier consistency. You don't want it to be runny because then it's going to, I guess, bleed out of the stencil, underneath the stencil. And so as I'm doing this, I'm thinking, okay, I'm not liking what I'm seeing. I had even tried to stir it a bit more to incorporate that cream more with the watery substance, I guess, that was in the container, and it just wasn't doing it. And if you look at the stencil itself, you can see where it's creamier in some areas and not so much in the other. And so I just decided, okay, we're gonna keep giving this a go and see what happens. The watery substance was absorbed into the sponge, and I did try to wring it out a bit, press it up against the sides of the container before I did this, but really when it's that watery, it's like putting water on this. You know, you're not gonna contain the water when you have a stencil. Just having a stencil isn't enough. And so I was already feeling like, okay, this isn't gonna work as well as other etching creams that I've used, but we're gonna give this a fair shot. I'm gonna do the full stencil and let's see what happens. Once I got the etching cream applied to the glass, the directions on the back say to let it set for about 15 to 30 minutes. And so in all honesty, I let it set for about an hour because I got caught up doing stuff around the house, kind of forgot about it, came back to it, and this is what I was presented with. You can see the true inconsistency of the cream. It just was not consistent at all. And I feel like had it been as thick as it was in those thicker areas, I feel like it would have worked better. I'm already not having high hopes for this, so I'm gonna go ahead and remove the stencil. And not to my surprise, it is a hot mess. There was a lot of bleedage with the stencil cream. It says to go ahead and rinse it off with warm water. I did do that, and this is the result. As it did etch the glass, it was too liquefied. And in my experience, and I have used etching cream before several times, I have never had the problem of using a stencil with the etching cream and it bleeding the way it did, because the etching cream is thicker. So when you apply it to the open areas of the stencil, in turn, it's supposed to just kind of stay there because it's a thicker consistency. And there really was no controlling the liquid in this Crafter Square etching cream because it was so liquefied. It just wasn't thick enough.
I wanted this to work better than it did. I really did. I'm a bit disappointed in it. I have used glass etching cream before and a medium that does glass etching, and it was a lot thicker. It was a lot creamier. I found that this one by Dollar Tree was very runny. I picked up 5 packs of it, and in all 5 packs, it leaked in all of the packs. I found that when I opened it up, it was very wet. It was very sticky. And when I opened up the etching cream itself, it just wasn't as thick as it needed to be. First impressions, I'm not super impressed. This is not Kelly Barlow approved, and I'm not gonna say that it's worth the dollar you spend, but if you wanna spend it just to try it out and see if you get a different result, maybe. But I've had better results with the glass etching cream that I bought at the craft stores. Now, I know that Dollar Tree always carries glitter. They have carried the ultra fine glitter for a while, but I've never really been happy with the colors. And this past week, I saw my Dollar Tree stocking the ultra fine glitter, and you're getting 6 in a pack, and it is a color variation on the same palette as all of the colors on it. So this would be the pink and purple palette. We've got the golds, orange, coppers, and browns on this one. I just thought that that was amazing. Love that. We've got the blues, greens, and silver here. This pack here, we've got the pearl, opalescent, the silvers, kind of the rose gold and black. 6 of these for a dollar, I think, is an amazing buy, and it's something that I figured was great just to add to my stash. I'm not a big glitter person, but I will say at Christmas time, it is fun to add to Santa's beard or like a Christmas tree that's green or an ornament. And so when I see stuff like this, I do like to pick it up and just kind of have it in my stash for that rainy day when we're gonna do some holiday DIYing. Another fun find, and this may be old news to some people, this may be no news to some people. Some people may live in an area that isn't wearing masks anymore. It's still mandated in our area, and even if it wasn't, I will just go ahead and tell you now that I would still be wearing a mask when I go out, and I probably will be for a while just for the safety and protection of my family. But I think it's really great that Dollar Tree now has these medical masks. And I know they've had the blue ones in the past, but they've got some real fun plaid ones. Now, I do wanna show you, they have a 2-pack for kids that have these adorable owls. So you know when I saw these, I had to pick them up. But what I love about these is I am very particular about my medical masks. I have bought the blue ones from Dollar Tree in the past that came in the 2-pack, and I wasn't super happy with them because I didn't like the wire for the nose. When you would go to bend it, it just didn't bend and it didn't form to your nose nicely. And that is kind of a deal breaker for me these days. It needs to form to my nose. How funny is that, that this is a conversation we're even having now. I bought these, and when you bend them, look at that. It forms nicely. We already opened them up and used them, and Allie was loving these. These fit nicely, they fit snug, and I just love that they've got cute, quality medical masks with a good wire for the nose. And so these are the adult ones. They came in several different colors and styles, and so I got the red and the blue, the cute blue, and the green and the blue, and I just thought that those were really fun, yeah, to put under our fabric masks. A couple random new finds. I love journals, and so when I was cashing out, I saw these. They're more silver than they are rainbow, but I think they're rainbow because my ring light is right above it. And it says, too inspired to be tired. Yes, that is the story of my life. Oh, there, it's kind of silver there. Yes, I am way too inspired to be tired. I don't have time for sleep. I'm so inspired these days. If you can dream, you can do it. These are amazing finds at the Dollar Tree, and I'm gonna tell you, this iPhone stand or phone stand, okay, I know it holds any phones, not just an iPhone, but I have an iPhone, so I say iPhone. This is amazing. When I'm working and doing stuff, I love the fact that I can sit my phone up, have it plugged in, and I can be on FaceTime with Allie, or I can be on FaceTime with Linda while she's working in the Etsy store, and I don't have to hold my phone. These are amazing. Another great item is this glow-in-the-dark cable protector. Have you seen these? How fun are these? Walmart used to carry these. They were about $2.88 a piece. They've got these real fun little animals that attach to your cord. And when you push it up into the part that plugs into your phone, it actually protects the cord from bending and breaking. And if you see these at the Dollar Tree, they had a few different cute little animals that you can use, but it's definitely worth the dollar that you pay for it. This here is Kelly Barlow approved.
This is a string cheese that I got from our fridge. It's a great snack on a nice summer's day. Now you open it. And this is what it looks like on the inside. You're just gonna take a little piece here. Mmm, delicious. Totally awesome.
Yes, this is totally awesome.
Fresh scent.
This is a bathroom cleaner.
Scum?
Oh, it says soap scum. Oh my good Lord, somebody help me. Okay, why am I showing you this? Because I think the packaging on this is amazing. And I'm not gonna lie to you. I don't typically buy my bathroom cleaner from Dollar Tree, but when I saw the packaging, I was all about it. Who doesn't do that when you see really cool packaging? You're like, oh, I think I need to have it because the packaging probably means it works great, right? Probably not, but I wanted to try it anyway. And I've never seen a cool bathroom cleaner like this. There may be one, I may be wrong. Somebody's gonna tell me in the comments, I know. But there's never been one that was this cool looking. So I bought it. This is in the fresh scent, like Kayla said, and it cleans soap scum, mold, all that fun stuff. Yeah, look. I've used it already. I love this stuff. It smells amazing. It smells like Pine Sol. It works great. I am somebody who every morning I go to each of my bathroom countertops, I spray them down with this or any cleaner that I was using. It really was Microban forever, but now it's this. And
it actually puts cleaning power in plain old water.
Look at that.
I'm gonna say that.
Does it? What does it say?
Actually puts cleaning power in plain old water.
Plain old water. Wait.
Taste test.
Yes. Oh. Somebody help me, please. It's Sunday night. This is being posted tomorrow, Monday, and I'm not in the mood to do this haul. And Kayla, truth be told, I asked Kayla to do this haul for me. I thought it would be fun, and she wouldn't do it.
I had to edit my video.
You were not editing. Tell them the truth.
No,
you were putting...
Oh, yeah, I was doing glitter, no. too.
Yes, yes. Wait.
Where is
Am I part of the haul?
Wait, where is it?
Am I part of this haul?
Kayla bought a ton of glitter. Kayla! You have to... This is staying in there.
You can't pick me up from the Dollar Tree, sorry.
No, you can't pick Kayla up from the Dollar Tree. Okay, so back to this. If you see this, you should try it because like I said, I spray down my bathroom counters every morning and just give them a quick wipe down, and this smells amazing. It doesn't leave streaks on your faucet, which is kind of a bummer when you use a bleached-based cleaner or any cleaner that has bleach in it. It leaves kind of that cloudy film. This doesn't. It left it nice, shiny, it smelled great, and I couldn't be happier with it. Every time I see it, when I need it, I am definitely using this. Last favorite find, yes, these are back. Do you know what this is, everybody? This is a Lazy Susan. Dollar Tree carried these years ago. I have not seen one, I would say, in probably 3 years. And so I picked up 5 of these. I was excited to see them. I did not take everything, I took 5. And there was probably about 20 or 30 of them. So I took my fair picking a 5 so I could bring you some really cool Dollar Tree DIYs using these here Lazy Susans for a dollar that are amazing by Essentials.
Today, Kayla is bringing to you part 3 of her Little Hope gameplay. If you've been following this series, you might want to head on over there today and see what happens in part 3. You can find the link to this video in the description box below. Sally Hansen gel nail polish. I have no other words. We all know that that nail polish is expensive, but it is amazing. And I absolutely love her polish. I don't buy the colored gel nail polish that doesn't need a light because it is $10.99. But I do, however, buy the top coat. I buy it in the gloss and the matte finish because it works so well with other polishes. When you put that top coat over it, you can really get a longer life out of your polish. And because I do my nails so often, I do feel the need to invest in a good top coat, and that is the one that I use. I would totally use more of her colored polishes if they were more budget friendly, but they're just not. But guess what? Since Dollar Tree had them, I bought every color because why not? It's a dollar and I am ecstatic over it. That extreme wear that she has as well is amazing. That one works just as good. Dollar Tree didn't have as big of a selection of that polish as they did as the gel, but I am not complaining. I hope you all enjoyed today's new finds at the Dollar Tree, and if you are interested in that Sally Hansen nail polish, you most definitely need to go to your Dollar Tree and look for it and get the getting while the getting is good, because you know once it's gone, it is really gone. And that is a money saver, a real one for me anyway, and I'm excited about it. You can guess what colors I'll be wearing here in the near future a lot. That's what I'm wearing now, the brown, love it. Right now my nails are a wreck from cleaning out the garage, so yeah, no bright colors for me, just some earth tones to kind of disguise the short nails. Anyway, now you know my secret. I hope you all enjoyed today's new finds. Please make sure to give this video a big thumbs up, and let's get this video to 5,000 likes. Because like I always say, each and every one of your thumbs up and those comments that you do leave down below, they really do help my channel to grow, and it helps YouTube to notice me just a bit more. Until next time, everybody, I hope you have a fantastic day. Happy everything on a budget. Stay happy, stay safe, stay healthy, but most of all, stay positive, please. And bye for now, everybody.